Liam, firstly, welcome back for the new season. Not only are you signed, the big news is you've signed for 2 years as well. So how good is it to have that sort of security going forward the next couple of years?
Yeah, it's really good. Obviously, I'm young, so getting that two-year deal in obviously means the clan are right into my development as well. So it's a really good thing for me, obviously. Gives me that bit of security as well. So I'm looking forward to that.
So what are your reflections of your progress last season? You didn't play much in the first half of the season, but you really came good in the second half. What have you made of that sort of progress you've made?
I felt I've progressed quite a bit. Obviously, I never played as much in that first half of the season. Then Christmas came and I started to play a little bit more. And then I started getting regular shift during the games as well. So obviously, I feel like I've improved quite a bit. Obviously, I'm looking to keep going the way I'm going as well. So hopefully this season, I keep going that way.
Of course, we always hear it's a big step up from the NIHL level. You've played with Solway Sharks up to the Elite League level. How do you feel you took to that kind of jump, and when did you feel as though you were finding your rhythm in that regard?
Obviously, the first couple of games didn't get as much ice time, but then once I started getting flung at all them situations, it just started clicking again. The speed got the feet back going again. And once I started going, there was no stopping me really.
And of course, you're playing against some really good players as well. So do you learn a lot about them as well as yourself in those situations?
Yeah, definitely. Obviously, just watching them makes me learn. I like to watch to learn. Obviously, some people like to watch videos. I like to watch in the person. I learn quite well from that. So obviously, watching them players play against me is really good for me to learn from them. So yeah, definitely.
So who was your trickiest opponent last year? I'm putting you on the spot a wee bit here.
Belfast always a tough one. Obviously, they were more superior team last season, and it's a long trip to go over there. Even when they come over to Glasgow as well, it's quite a tough one. So yeah, I'll probably say Belfast.
And how much did working with experienced guys like Cody Saul and Brock Bookaboom help you as well? What kind of advice were they giving you, not only in practice but through games as well?
Oh yeah, obviously I played quite a bit with Cody Saul. He was really good. He took me under his wing. Taught me quite a few things during practice. Obviously, during games, it was the only thing I could hear him at ear the whole time, tell me what to do, give me a little bit of advice here and there. And obviously, all the guys on the bench, if I came off, if I was feeling a bit down, if I'd done something wrong, obviously, they'd all tell me these things happen, what to do to not let it happen again, what to do to improve on things. So, yeah, it's really good. I love working with experienced guys. Obviously, them filtering down their experience onto me, it's really good.
So not only working with those guys, Malcolm Cameron, I know, was quite big on working with younger players as well. How much encouragement did you get from him throughout the season?
Oh yeah, really good encouragement from Malcolm. Obviously, he brought me in at that Christmas time and put a lot of trust in me, playing me in all them situations. So obviously it's good to play under an experienced coach like him. He's got a lot of years coaching in him, so yeah, it's really good.
And you must take it as a huge compliment, the fact that he kept trusting you in those situations as well. He wasn't afraid to put you in against some of the quality of players that you were up against.
Yeah, definitely. It proves that he does have that trust in me. He believes that I can do the job for him. And I guess that's really what a young guy needs, is a coach that will believe in him and let him play in all them situations. So, yeah, I really enjoy playing under Malcolm.
So I'm putting you on the spot again with this one. Apart from your goal against Manchester Storm back in January, what were your personal highlights from last season? Can you think of any?
Hey, obviously, getting them first couple of games in was really good. Getting to experience that Elite League again, getting on the ice again, getting back up to speed with it all. I think that's probably the highlight for me is then starting to play them more minutes and playing as many games as I could.
So this season, brand new campaign. We're a couple of months away from that, of course. How big is it for your own personal development looking ahead?
Oh yeah, I feel like it's the right time for me to step up. Obviously, this is the last year I've had at college. Just trying to get all that work done just now before the deadlines. And then obviously I feel like it's the perfect time for me to step up in terms of my development. I feel like I'm at the right stage and I just need to get that extra jump and keep improving as I'm going.
And of course, I know all the guys down at Solway are absolutely proud of you for the way you've stepped up into the Elite League game as well. What will they make of this news, the fact that you've been handed a two-year contract as well? I'm sure they'll be proud as punch for you.
Oh, yeah, I'm sure they'll be ecstatic. Obviously, I can't thank the Solway committee, the staff, everyone involved in the club. Obviously, my family and my girlfriend down here as well. They've been great helping me out getting all this stuff done. to get me onto this contract. So yeah, I'm sure they'll be ecstatic for me, and I can't thank them all enough.
And we're starting to see some excitement about the team starting to come into some kind of shape now. The fans are getting excited for the new season. As I say, still a couple of months away before we see any action on the ice. But as a player, are you excited yet for next season, or will that come later on? You're just quite happy with the downtime right now and doing what you've got to do in the meantime.
Yeah, I'm excited all the time. I'm quite an energetic person, so yeah, I feel like I'm getting excited for the season already. I felt excited when Malcolm first spoke to me about next year. But yeah, I'm enjoying the downtime, obviously spending more time with the family. Obviously I'm going on holiday at the start of July as well, so I'm looking forward to that. I'm going away with the family next week as well. So yeah, I'm enjoying the downtime, but obviously I'm excited about getting into that season.
And you kind of covered my next question there about what you'll be doing over the next couple of months. But I'm also keen to know about when you start getting yourself ready for the new season as well. I dare say that there's getting yourself in shape so that when come practice time and the team are all together, you're good to go. When does all that start for you?
I've started, to be honest. I work in a gym now.
That's
Obviously, I started working
handy.
in the gym. I started working in the gym near the end of last year. So yeah, obviously I can go in and work out whenever I want. So I've started as soon as the last game was played last season. The next week I was into my pre-season already. So yeah.
There you go. Never a man to let the grass grow underneath your feet. Well, finally, as I always like to finish with, a chance for you to speak directly to the Purple Army, the fans watching this. What would you like to say to them?
Yeah, I'm super excited to get started again. Obviously, I love playing in front of you guys. You're definitely the best fans in the league by far. So yeah, hopefully I see you all again soon and we get that building rocking again.